Thank you very much. My name is Danielle Huls from Ketting Huls. It's a Dutch architect firm. We are based in the harbor area of the Amsterdam in the Netherlands. And our projects are dealing with the lived environment, human perception and memories and imagination. And we do not believe in destroying the old to make room for the new. We focus on what's there, the cultural history and the social context, and on the qualities of the place. And for us, that's the social sustainability. Is it working? The other way around, okay. One of our projects, for example, integrates an existing waterway with a little forest into a housing block, which is turned into a collective garden for the inhabitants. An extension to a villa where we used a roofscape to make a new one, or a pavilion within a park in Maastricht where the pergola forms a terrace where the neighbors from the adjacent neighborhoods can meet and greet. But mainly I want to talk about this project, which is Vliervelde. It's an apartment block which we built on a still operating farmyard in the Netherlands. It's built in Flevoland, which is newly made land in the Netherlands, made in the 70s, and which is at the moment the most fertile ground, agricultural ground in the Netherlands. And our client, the farmer, he bought a plot of 40 hectares of agricultural land there. It's the green spot with the red square in it. And it's part of Oosterwold, where it is possible to also build houses integrated within the agricultural land, and according to a plan of MVRDV. And this is the plot that he bought, and at the moment the farmer will operate there as a biological dynamic farm, a biodynamic farm, which means that the cows that he has and the manure that that the cows will give him, he will use to fertilize his land. So it's a very integrated ecosystem in which he operates. This is the plot again, and down there in the left corner you see the yard as it is now realized. And it was a very organic process where the farmer first built the layout for his farmland, so the road system and the waterway. And on the right hand above there you see the layout of the yard itself. And first he built the cow shed and the hay barn, and later on seven single family houses are realized and the apartment building that we did. So first of all the cow shed at the hay barn. So the cows were basically the first inhabitants that were there on the plot, and the manure of the cows is used to fertilize the ground, which is in this concept an important thing to know. And in the next phase we built the apartment block with the gate onto the farm yard and as an entrance to the farm. As you all know, we have this nitrogen problem in the world, and especially also in the Netherlands, in Europe. And so the nitrogen is not only emission by cars and industry, but also by the manure of the livestock that we have. It, as we all know, enriches the soil and decreases the biodiversity, which is really a problem, and we try to solve it also in Europe, but especially in the Netherlands, because as you see, the Netherlands is the one that has the most polluted nitrogen emission of Europe. And it is mainly due to the fact that we have, in a very small country, the most, really a lot of livestock and mega stalls. So it is really a problem that we have to deal with, but which also causes a lot of tension between political parties in the Netherlands, the people who live in within the cities versus the farmers who live on the countryside. And so at the moment, a very important topic. And I think our project in Vliervelde is one of the possible solutions for this problem. Because what happened there is that, for farmers to downsize from a mega stall with 250 cows to a cow shed with only 50, they need money. And this money is very difficult to borrow from the banks at the moment in the Netherlands. So what happened in Vliervelde is that the farmer was allowed to sell his farmer ground, or you could say his the ground that he part of the ground that is basically cheaper as building ground, and the money that he earned with it he could use to transform his farm into a biodynamic farm. So in that sense, a very one of the ways that we can solve a problem to create farms with less nitrogen pollution or emission, but also solve the problem now in the Netherlands that we really need more houses. And that's what happened in Vliervelde. And next to that, it's also a multifunctional farm. So it means it's a place where not only the farmer works, but he also lives together with the apartment block, seven single family houses, and but there is also a nursery, a farm shop and a cafe. So it's not a single function a place or yard, but a multifunctional farm. So that also means that on the plot, it's not only the farm and the work, or the farmer and the workers that are there together with his 50 cows, but also the inhabitants of 25 apartments, the children who go to the nursery, the people who pass by to do shopping in the farm shop, and also then the people who live in the single family houses. So that creates an agricultural community where a farmer and people meet, a place which is very sustainable, but where people also learn to understand each other and make the tension that we have now in the Netherlands between civilians and farmers less, especially because if you live together, you start to understand each other, and it's a start in solving the problem that we have in the Netherlands at the moment. So but Vliervelde at the moment is the first or unique in the Netherlands, because it is not possible to build a cow shed next to or an apartment block next to a cow shed because of the law and the regulations that we have, and the especially in relation to the cow smell. And that makes it very, at the moment not really possible. But as you see in Almere, we managed to do this, and the municipality was willing to cooperate with it, and they found a way to deal with it and to make it possible. So at the moment we are sort of, you could say, on tour together with Rabobank, which is a bank who really invests into farmers, but not yet that much into biodynamic farmers. But together with them and the developer, we are touring around and have workshops and try to work together with other farmers and municipalities to see how we can also create other Vliervelders around the Netherlands as one solution to the problems that we are dealing with. And what you see also here in the images is that although it's a collage of different buildings with different functions, recreated by the scape of the roofs and the very agricultural use of the materials, we created a coherent building complex. And the houses itself, or the apartments, they have very big, generous balconies and galleries, all made in wood with a wood facade. And this is here you can see how the building sort of goes together with the agricultural buildings and their architecture, and how also it is integrated within the surrounding landscapes together with the gate as entrance. And as a last image where you can see how the whole setting is settled within the Dutch landscape, very flat. Okay, thank you for your attention.